Hello, myself Sukanta De, a PhD scholar from the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati, Assam, India. So, I am recording this video in case if I do not able to attend the ISVLSI 2018, my paper's title is Reliability Constraint, Airdrop Minimization and Electromigration Assessment of VLSI Power Grid Networks Using Cooperative Coevolution. So let's begin. So in the overview, this is the overview of the presentation. So initially I will talk about the introduction. So then I will tell about the problem formulation of my problem. Then I will tell the proposed methodology. Then I will discuss the results. And at the end, I will do the conclusion. So what is a power grid network? So power in a chip to transfer the power from the power pits to the functional blocks, power lines and ground lines are constructed, and these are called, these are in general called power grid network. So why power grid is important in today's world scenario? Since the size of the chip is increasing and the transistor count is becoming billions, so to transfer the power to all the transistors become very difficult, and the metal and the power lines are normally made of metal lines, and these metal lines have different parasitic resistances, capacitances, inductances. So this, due to this, there are power losses, and there are different kinds of power losses and different kinds of noise occur. So one such kind of noise is voltage drop noise. So voltage drop noise occurs due to the IR drop noise and the LDIDT noise. So in this work, I am considering only the IR drop effects, and I will try to show that how we can minimize it and how the minimization of IR drop helps the aging of the chip. So you, in this diagram, you can see a picture where the functional blocks are powered using the metal lines, which is nothing with the power grid network. So those blocks due to the length of the metal lines, there are some voltage drop occurs, and the blocks do not get the exact power what it is designed for. The VDD voltage is 1.8 volt, and the blocks are not getting 1.8 volt, but something less than this. And if this voltage becomes less than a certain level, then the blocks may malfunction. So the analysis and optimization of this power grid is very much important. So motivation. So as I said, you can newer technologies are using many computational units. For example, Apple, today's Apple chips are 4.3 billion transistors, and the diarrhea is at 87.6 millimeter square, and the supply voltage is 0.7 volt. So transferring this 0.7 volt to 4.3 is very difficult. And in future, the number of transistor count will be 10 billions. So it will be very difficult for the designers to design, and it will take lots of manpower and time. So the reliability of these chips have become a big issue. So what are the longevity of these chips? So from power grid perspective, what are the reliability issues? So the power grid network may fail, and that is already I have told. If the if there is significant amount of voltage drop noise or the IR drop noise, then these power lines may fail. Also, this due to electromigration, which is nothing but when the currents, when the electrons transfer the momentum to the metal atoms, and then there is a some transfer of mass of electrons, and some masses are drifted and voids created, and some there are some hillocks formed at somewhere, and in this way some short circuit and open circuit may open there, and that causes the reliability issues. And also due to thermal noise, voltage drop issue and electromagnetic issues may occur. So you can see the voltage drop map of a IBM chip. So in the red areas are the most affected areas due to the IR voltage drop or the IR drop noise. So the related works, so here basically what I am doing, I am trying to minimize this IR drop. So the related works in this power grid network is, in the people have tried to do the area minimization of the power grid networks, you formulating as a two-phase optimization problem. So initially Tan et al. In 1991 and 2001-2003 have solved this using sequence of linear, and there are lots of work, similar kind of work, which tried to optimize, minimize the area of the power grid network considering IR drop as a constraint, but they do not try to minimize the IR drop. And also recent research development shows that the people are researchers are proposing different physics based model for the optimistic electromigration based aging prediction. So here in this work, I am doing the IR drop minimization, and for that I am formulating IR drop minimization problem as a large scale optimization problem. And we are solving this large scale optimization problem using cooperative correlation method, and this method is able to solve the IR drop noise significantly. And we also showed that the EM assessment of the power grid is after the IR drop minimization shows a optimistic prediction in the lifetime of the chip. So this is the power grid. So niche, normally the power grids are very complicated network. So we are forming it as a steady state network considering only the resistance elements, and for the functional blocks we have designed it as a current source going to the ground. So, and we have done all our analysis and optimization for such a circuit, such netlist. So I know the optimize objective function we have made is very simple. So for a metal line which is carrying current I and which has the resistance R, the IR drop will be I into R. And for the whole power grid network, if we sum up all those individual power grids, that will be a total sum of the total IR drop of the whole chip. And in the paper you can see in that we have proved that if we minimize the total IR drop of the chip, then the worst case IR drop, which is the main concern, will also reduce. So that is not, the proof is not shown here due to the time constraints. And different constants we are handling is, one is the IR drop constants, which people have used earlier. So the IR drop is basically the node voltage between the two consecutive nodes will be less than some epsilon, some eta. And then the summation of all the metal lines areas should be less than Amax, that is the total area constraints. Another is electromigration constraint, that is the current density of a single metal line should not be greater than Im. And also the minimum area constraint, which is the minimum area of a metal line should be W min. And also in every node the KCL should follow, that is our fifth constraint. So in this way we are trying to minimize the total IR drop considering this constraint, and in this way we'll get that the worst case IR drop has minimized. So we have used the cooperative coagulation method. So this is a divide and conquer method. So for large number of variables, we basically divide it in different sub components, and then we try to optimize each of the sub components using a different optimizer algorithm. So you can see here initially the population is divided by some grouping method, then each sub population is optimized using some optimizer, then after all the population from all the sub solution base solutions from the sub components are accommodated, and a total base solution is covered. And for the airdrop minimization, we have adopted this algorithm, and the optimizer we have used is neighborhood search, self-adapted neighborhood search and differential evolution algorithm. So that is our optimizer, and it has shown the improvement over the other differential evolution algorithms. So the input to our airdrop minimization algorithm is the branch width and the current ranges, and this current ranges is been found after the doing the power grid analysis using KLU solver. So and the output will be the optimized netlist which have the minimized airdrop. So initially we have constructed a search space using those constraints we have declared earlier. Then for this inside the search space, initially the cooperative coagulation base for SNSD, which is a multiple self-adaptive neighborhood search for differential with random grouping, has been initialized. Then after that, for the random grouping is employed to decompose the V variables in each subcomponents. Then the SNSD algorithm is used to optimize each of the subcomponent, and again the all the base solutions of each subcomponents are accommodated using random grouping. In this way we get the optimized material width for the minimized airdrop of the total airdrop of the power grid network. And then the again power grid analysis is done to find the worst case airdrop. And as we say earlier, this minimization of airdrop has demonstrated improvement in the lifetime prediction of the chip. So we have done the EM assessment using two methods. One is Black series method. Black's in 1979 has proposed mean time to failures equation, and that is very famous, that is still induced in the industry. That you can see. So using that for each of the interconnects, the weakest interconnect or the line with the weakest current density has been taken as the mean time to failure of the chip. As I said, the physics-based model used by the Wang et al. So I have also used that for the EM assessment, and that in the physics-based model proposed by Wang et al. The EM induced voltage drop increases with the prolonged duration. They have showed the EM induced voltage drop increases the prolonged duration of time. When this voltage drop crosses the threshold, is considered as a failure criteria. So I have also similarly done. I have done the electromigration, and we have implemented this all the algorithms in MATLAB in a Linux based system with a 632 GB memory. We have tested our algorithm on IBM PowerGrid benchmarks, which is a standard benchmark which is available online. So these are the characteristics of the benchmarks. So the benchmarks, which is the nodes and different nodes and different branches, and the resistance ranges are given. This is available in the website, you can see. And for this data, we have done initially the airdrop worst case airdrop minimization. So before minimization, all the airdrops are greater than after the minimization. So we have got significant improvement in the airdrop, significant airdrop minimization using our proposed method for all the circuits. And similarly, in the electromigration based my mean time to failure comparison, we have got improvement. As you can see, for the Black's equation, before minimization, the life mean time to failure was 7.81 years. So after the minimization of airdrop, the mean time to failure has increased to 11.21 years. Similarly, and even for the Huang et al.'s model, we have got the improvement for the after the minimization. Similarly, the electromigration based MTTF has been calculated for all these benchmark circuits, and we have got improvement as in the optimistic prediction of the power grid network power grid network aging. We have got improvement in the optimistic prediction. So that's all in our paper. So in this paper presents a minimization. So here we have basically tried to show that how can we minimize the airdrop method, and we have formulated a large scale optimization problem, and we have tried to minimize that using cooperative correlation based method. And the optimizer we have used is SenseD, and this airdrop minimization is done at the cost of the metallicity of the chip. As you can know, the results show minimization of airdrop for different power grid benchmarks. Further electromagnetic of the optimized power grid is done to demonstrate the optimism in the lifetime prediction of the power grid network. And that's all. Thank you.